वेलकम चिल्ड्रन, प्रोसीडिंग विद आर रूटीन टॉपिक दैट इज इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस एंड टेकिंग सम मोर एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम इट, कंटिन्यूइंग विद द मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज. सी द नाइन्थ क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट प्रूविंग इट. सो वी आर गोइंग टू प्रूव टैन इनवर्स माइनस रूट एक्स इज इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ कॉस इनवर्स वन माइनस एक्स ओवर वन प्लस एक्स. एंड वी आर ऑलरेडी गिवन एक्स बिलोंग्स टू द क्लोज इंटरवल जीरो टू one. Now we can proceed from the right hand side. If you look at the right hand side, you will get a hint what substitution should be used for x. We all know that cos 2 theta, sin 2 theta, tan 2 theta, they all can be written in terms of tan theta. Okay, so keeping that in mind, those results, let us put x is equal to tan square theta. That means tan theta can be converted into root x, and if required, theta can be replaced by tan inverse root x. So the right hand side reduces to half of cos inverse 1 minus tan square theta over 1 plus tan square theta. Now this is the formula for cos 2 theta. Now can we replace cos inverse cos 2 theta by 2 theta? That can be justified from here. Though, as I told you earlier, you can write it directly, because every time the domain given to you will support your step and you will find the angle is belonging to the required principal branch. Okay, but still let us go for the explanation here. We know x is less than equal to 1 but greater than equal to 0. And what is x equal to? It is tan square theta. So tan square theta is greater than equal to 0 but less than equal to 1. Now 1 in terms of tan can be written as tan pi by 4. We can even write it as square of tan pi by 4. In the same way, 0 can be written as square of tan 0. That means theta is an angle which is less than equal to pi by 4 but greater than equal to 0. Because our angle over here is twice of theta, so multiplying each of them by 2, we get 2 theta is greater than equal to 0 but less than equal to pi by 2. Now you recall the principal value branch for this function, cos inverse. For that, 2 theta should lie in the close interval 0 to pi. If you see here, 2 theta is taking the angles, the values of the angles which belong to the close interval 0 to pi. All these angles will lie in that interval. So we can replace cos inverse cos 2 theta by 2 theta. So half of 2 theta reduces it to theta. And what is theta equal to? It is tan inverse root x, which is our required left hand side. Okay, then see the next one. We need to show cot inverse square root of 1 plus sin x plus square root of 1 minus sin x divided by square root of 1 plus sin x minus square root of 1 minus sin x is equal to x by 2. And x is given to be in the interval 0 to pi by 4. Now see here, we will first learn how to simplify these, then we are going to substitute them. Now 1 plus sin x is given to us. 1 can be written as in the form sin square theta plus cos square theta. Now theta is taken as x by 2. Keeping this in mind that sin x can be written as 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2. So you can see the angle here is x by 2. So while changing 1, I have written it as sin square x by 2 plus cos square x by 2. Now you read this entire expression as a whole, you will find it is a perfect square. So a square plus b square plus twice of ab can be written as a plus b whole square. So we have square root of a perfect square. So that gives us a simple value corresponding to it. That is sin x by 2 plus cos x by 2. Same we are going to do for the expression square root of 1 minus sin x. So 1 is replaced by sin square x by 2 plus cos square x by 2. And sin x is replaced by 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2 with a negative sign here. Okay. So it will take the form a minus b whole square. Now whether we should write it as sin x by 2 minus cos x by 2 whole square, or we should write it as cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 whole square, that will entirely depend on this. we will see the value of x, and for those values of x we have to check whether cosine is greater than sine or sine is greater than cosine. Accordingly the difference will be written. Okay, so before we go through this, look at this part. It is given x is less than pi by 4 but greater than 0. Okay, so x is from 0 to 45 degree. That means x by 2 will be from 0 to pi by 8. Pi by 8 is smaller than pi by 4. So this angle x by 2 belongs to that interval where cosine function is greater than sine. Keep in mind, cos theta is greater than sine theta from 0 to 45 degrees. From 45 to 90 degree, sine becomes greater than cosine. You can check the graph. From there, you will be able to make out. So you have to see this interval very carefully. Whether in this interval cosine is greater or sine is greater, accordingly the difference will be mentioned. So what do we see in this interval? Cos x by 2 will be greater than sine x by 2. So square root of minus 1 minus sine x should be written as cos x by 2 minus sine x by 2. Now quickly doing the substitution and cancelling out the terms. See, in the numerator sine x by 2 gets eliminated, in the denominator cos x by 2. So we are left with 2 cos x by 2 over 2 sine x by 2 within this bracket. 2 and 2 gets cancelled out. Cos x by 2 over sine x by 2 is cot x by 2. So we can replace cot inverse cot x by 2 by x by 2, which is the right hand side. Provided, you know, the angle would have been say x is from pi by 4 to pi by 2. Okay, and this was becoming cos x minus sine x whole square or sine x minus cos x whole square. So we will again check, because if x will be greater than pi by 4 but less than pi by 2, then sine x will become greater than cos x. So if that would have been the case, we would have written it as sine x minus cos x whole square. So this will play an important role in deciding this part. When it is about addition, it hardly makes any difference. But when it is about subtraction, you have to be very careful. Now moving on to the 11th one, we will show tan inverse square root of 1 plus x minus square root of 1 minus x divided by this whole is pi by 4 minus half of cos inverse x. Value of x is given to us. We will use it if required to check. Now substituting x by cos 2 theta. The reason why we are taking x cos 2 theta, because we can define what is 1 plus cos 2 theta. We can also define 1 minus cos 2 theta. These are the results we have done in class 11th. So if x is cos 2 theta, 2 theta will become cos inverse x. Or we can say theta will become half of cos inverse x. So replace x by its value in the given expression, the left hand side. Recall the results you have done. 1 plus cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta, and 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sine square theta. So replace both of them using the formula. So you can see the expression is reducing to tan inverse square root of 2 cos square theta. So if I take square root, it is root 2 cos theta. And what about the later part? It will be root 2 sine theta. Same in the denominator. It is root 2 cos theta plus root 2 sine theta. Square root of 2 we can take common and cancel out. And this is what we are left with. Cos theta minus sine theta in the numerator. Cos theta plus sine theta in the denominator. So think of converting them in terms of tan theta. If I divide the numerator and the denominator by cos theta, this will become cos theta by cos theta, which is 1. Sin theta over cos theta will be tan theta. So in the same manner, in the denominator, cos theta over cos theta is 1. Sin theta over cos theta is tan theta. Now, if you can quickly recall, this is expansion of tan pi by 4 minus theta. So now the given expression has reduced to tan inverse tan pi by 4 minus theta, which can be written as pi by 4 minus theta, where theta is half cos inverse x. That is the right hand side.